other teams travel with us.
That's all right. Come on. It's fine.
Save time. Save money. Fly with the Air Travel Group.
Full count.
Working, buddy. Come on. Back off a touch.
Yes, okay. Oh, short and out.
And that's the base on balls for Hagelin. So the first three have reached. And now stepping into the box, it'll be the catcher, number 30, Jeremy Yates. Jeremy already with seven home runs in this World Series.
Come on, buddy.
The winner of last night's home run derby. Yep.
2-0. Pick it up a little.
And that one is laced to right. Will it stay fair? It does. It's gone. Jeremy Yates, a two-run line drive home run, and Backman jumps out with four quick runs. Still nobody out, and into the box the shortstop, Ryan Sobol. Ryan, 8 out of 12, 6 home runs. A team high 15 runs batted in.
Come on, get the bunches in a row. Let's go. Come on.
Pipe.
Good start.
And
And Ryan Stovall with the base hit to left. He makes the big turn, but slips in the morning dew. Looks like Ryan's okay. Give him a single, and it'll bring up the left fielder, number 6, Reggie Schulte.
Let's go.
And then I found a chair.
Fly ball to deep left field, but it stays in the park. Andrew Collins back to the wall to haul it in. So now one away, Stovall to second. And stepping into the box, it'll be the middle infielder. Number 11 from Orlando, Florida, it's Orlando Castillo.
Plate.
Yeah.
Nope. I hit the plate too.
Come on, work, buddy, work. Come on.
Oh yeah, we got these.
What's that?
Hot smash up the middle, deflected by Purcell. Reyna makes a great attempt, but a hustling Castillo beats it for the infield single. So now two on with one out, and a chance for the second baseman, number 1. Stephen Lloyd.
Wait.
People, I will not get through that camera.
Yep. Nope. Stay in.
Come on, keep working, buddy. Come on. Get me out of this. Come on. Fuck
it. Ah, really tried. Sorry, DJ.
I understand.
2-0.
11 a.m.
Yeah, but
I'll get me back
okay, if I said 12. 10. I guess I need to let you catch it. I ain't got no
gloves. And that's the base on balls from Stephen Lloyd. So now they're loaded up. And stepping into the box, it'll be the center fielder, number 2 from Sandston, Virginia, Brian Logan.
It's
like,
it's part.
Me and on some shit. We go 0-100 for real quick.
Play.
I'd rather stay here all day, but I feel like even with my energy, I'd stay
here. Outside.
I would be playing all the way back. Yeah, right. That's why I think you go home and might have played a bit in this morning.
Hey,
I just realized.
Play.
And that's the base on balls for Logan. Stovall will trot in to score the 5th run of the inning. Base is still loaded, and now we go to the pitcher, number 18, Andrew Vincent. And a big defensive play. Hot smash to third. Bubba Mac starts it. The great turn at second base. And then a stretching Sanchez at first just nips Fitzek. So the inning-ending double play. Backman gets 5 in the first. They get those 5 runs on the strength of 5 hits. We will go to the top of the second. Do a full Collins and Santana.
What is he? Question.
Saturday morning. DW here on the mic. See a little bit of the highlights of the home run derby last night. Big Ryan Harvey going over the scoreboard twice. But the derby was won by his teammate, Jeremy Yates. Harvey was in the finals. Bubba Mack was in the finals. Davis Bilardello was the fourth member of the finals of the Home Run Derby last night on MLB.com. We are live here Saturday morning. Resmondo in the orange and white batting in the top of the second. They put up a zero in the first.
I don't think anybody was, really. I mean.
And Backman in the gray and white out in the field. They put up a five spot in the bottom of the first on five hits. Ended the inning with a double play.
32 minutes, maybe 32 seconds.
Stepping into the box to lead things off, it'll be the big catcher, number 15, playing out of King, North Carolina, B.J. Polk. B.J., team high 7 home runs, a team high 15 runs driven in so far.
B.J. Polk going to lead things off for Resmondo. Defense for Backman, Vitzak on the mound, Yates at catcher. Third base, Lee Powers, shortstop, Ryan Stovall. Middle infielder, Orlando Castillo. Second base is Stephen Lloyd. First base, Kevin Kennington. Second pitch to Folk, swung on deep right, but playable. Back goes Haglin, makes the catch.
One away, and now stepping into the box, it'll be the left fielder. Number 3, Andrew Collins.
Number 1, Backman. Number 2, Resmondo. Meeting here in the loser's bracket semifinals. Both teams, if they want to win the championship today, would have to win 5 games today. Collins the batter. Of course, Resmondo had that huge 17 runs in the 6th and 7th inning to beat line drive yesterday. Collins hits it foul. You have the home plate umpire mic'd, so that's who you're hearing. The wind flag is not moving. No wind this morning. Swung on up the middle base hit. Collins. Bring up the lefty Santana. Then Luis Reyna. And then Don DeDonatis Jr.
So one on and one out for the center fielder, number 21, playing out of Longwood, Florida, Nick Santana. Nick, the outstanding offensive player in last
5-0 Backman, top of the second. The winner will get the winner of Combat and 3rd Street, and we'll play next. And that game will be at 3 o'clock. Winner's Bracket Championship, of course, at 1 with the scene. Taking on Smash It Sports.
One. Full count.
Full count to Santana. Ball must be fair. Swung on, hit deep right field. Back goes Haglin to the wall. Off the base of the wall. Kicks away from Haglin. Collins got a good jump on. He's going to score from first. Santana in with a triple.
And that one off the ESPN Live Road Sports lettering in deep right center field. It's a stand-up RBI triple. Collins in to score the first run of the game for Resmondo. And now with another run just 75 feet away, stepping into the box.
Go to the replay here. Santana took an inside pitch. He got all of it. Haglin did not get a great jump on it. Ball kicked off the bottom of the fence. For an RBI triple, Resmondo on the board, trailing 5-1. Looks like Brian Logan in center. Ball hit down the left field line.
And, that ball is
and gone
here.
Up on the Logan hill.
Reyna banging it over
two
the
run shot by Reyna.
That's a two run shot. Luis's
5-3. Santana scores.
Now nobody out for the shortstop. He'll be entering the Hall of Fame later in the fall. Number three, playing out of Kissimmee, Florida, Don Deedonatis.
Deedonatis battling a elbow injury this weekend.
Play.
Looks like we got some stats here for both teams. That ball's hit to center, blooping in and going to fall in front of Logan. Now kicks away from him. Deedonatis is going to be scored a double. Deedonatis batting 625 coming into the game. Looks like the home run leader for Rosmondo, Greg Cannell with 6, Andy Purcell 5, Bubba Mack, Dan Sanchez with 4 apiece, and actually B.J. Falk with 7 homers, 15 RBIs. Team hitting 607 coming into the game with 32 homers in 4 games. Batter is the lefty Lee Payne. Payne 2 for 3. Actually, 6 for 9, 667.
Nope, a little bit. Short night,
coming into
short.
The game.
Good pitch.
Runner on second, one out. Second pitch from Vitsack missed.
Uno. Play.
And that's the base on balls for Lee Payne.
And Lee Payne walks. Going to bring up Dan Sanchez, who's moved into the starting lineup at first base. He's 5 for 6 in the tournament with 4 homers and 6 RBIs. He had that huge shot to right center field yesterday against line drive to tie the game. Runners on first and second. Sanchez got all of that one. That one's headed for the Helmer wall. And one hops the yellow wall in right field. Sanchez with a 3-run shot. And Rosmondo's first lead of the game, 6-5.
And we go back to the top for Greg Cannell.
Here's your replay. Sanchez, 5th homer in 7 at bats. Sanchez locked in. Bottom of the order. Doing a lot of damage for Rosmondo in the last 2 games. Cannell, the leadoff hitter, 14 of 18 in the tournament, 778. Hammers it deep center. Logan looks up.
Solo. Well out of here. Greg Cannell with the home run to left center field. 7-5.
Ball is flying this morning. A little bit cooler. Ball's probably been in the air conditioning all night. First game's usually a high scoring one. Backman manager Dal Beggs out to talk it over. After the delay, Andy Purcell going to stand in. Bubba Mack on deck. B.J. Falk in the hole. Rosmondo with a 7-5 lead, top of the second. One out, nobody on. Playing Purcell Deadpool. And he hits it deep. It's going to carry towards the fence. And up on the hill, Purcell's got himself his sixth homer of the tournament.
That makes it 8-5 and into the box.
Smano doing it mostly with the long ball here in the second. 8 runs across. There's your swing by Purcell.
What?
Bubba Mack. First pitch swinging center field, going to fall in, base hit.
Base hit for Bubba Mack. So the first
starting to get a feel like this may be headed for about 40 runs. First one to 40 might win this one. First man putting up that zero in the first. Could come back to haunt him. BJ Falk, the batter. Combat in 3rd Street, your next game.
What? Nope, a little flat, sir. Strike! That one got a corner.
Falk hit the comeback walk-off home run to beat line drive yesterday.
Play.
Playing BJ to pull. That was down the middle, swung on, popped up. It's going to be a long run for the right fielder, Hagelin, who makes the catch. 2 out.
Time! Got 2 guys.
So the high fly ball into shallow center field, the long run for Neil Hagelin, he gathers it in.
BJ's going to get a good pitch to hit, but missed it. Look at the swing. It was right in the wheelhouse.
Started the left fielder, Andrew Collins.
Didn't quite get on top of it. 2 outs for Collins. Collins, an Orlando, Florida native. Runner on first, 2 out. Playing him to the left side. Swung on, first pitch, knuckling. Left fielder's not going to get there. Reggie Schulte, it's up against the wall. Collins walks in the second with a double.
To left center fielder Andrew Collins. Bubba Mack racing around to third. So now 2 men in scoring position for the center fielder, number 21, Nick Santana.
Nick Santana, 7 for 15 coming into the game. A homer and 4 RBIs. Mondo in the tournament, 4 games, 12 walks. Backman, 3 games, 14 walks. Tana takes a ball outside.
Strike!
Fence here, 335 down the left field line, 385 to the gaps, 400 to center. Swung on, base hit. It's going to score 2. Smano with a 10-run inning, and they're up 10-5. Fence down the right field line says 335. If you Google Earth it, it's 315.
So it's a 10-run inning, 2 outs, and into the box, Luis Reyna.
A little magic there done by Disney. Luis Reyna.
Play. Strike!
Reyna homered last time up. Runner on first, 2 out. Inside.
One.
Luis is not listed in the stats they gave me. To figure out why. Right fielder's shallow, left fielder deep. Swung on center field, playable. Logan cruises in, makes the catch.
And the fly ball is straight away.
And Rosmano gets 10 runs in the top of the second. They lead 10-5. Beckman coming up.
Side, but Rosmano puts up a double-digit inning. They get 10 runs on 10 hits. Included in those 10 hits are 4 home runs. We go to the bottom half of any number. Soon it'll be the top of the order for Beckman, Powers, Kennedy, and Hagman.
Saving for a big man cave. Good luck with that, Dave. You made the most of your retirement plan, so you better learn to drive that RV, man. So many things you're doing in your life. Nationwide is on your side.
All right, we're back. Bottom of the second.
And
Beckman's Lee Powers leads things off with a walk. They almost batted around in the first, scored 5 runs. Rosmano got 10 on the top of the second. 10-5 your score. A little discussion on some of the websites about the ball. Of course, it flies better in the morning. There's no denying that. It's cooler. Balls are cooler. Well, they're all stored in the same place, so pretty much the same temperature all day, I would say. We've always seen higher scores here in the morning, though. And if you just watch the game, you can see it flying pretty good. These two teams have combined for 65 homers in 7 games. That's less than 10 a game. We already have 15 runs in like inning and a half. Pretty obvious. Double there by the two-hitter Kennington. Bring up Neil Hagelin. Hagelin, 583, 3 homers, 6 RBIs, coming into the game.
I got you. Put that there. Play. Oh, that's heavy.
Nice pitch by Purcell, just missed.
One's right, got the corner.
Got the corner, 1-1. Must be fair. No foul on the second strike. Inside pitch, hammered to right field. It's going to score 2. 10-7. Now the lead for Rosmano. We'll set the defense. Andy Purcell pitching. BJ Falk catching left to right in the infield. Bubba Mack, Don DeDonatis. Luis Reyna, second base. Greg Cannell, first base. First base is Dan Sanchez. Left to right in the outfield, Collins, Santana, and Payne.
Five.
Jeremy Yates, conference MVP.
Two notes.
Home run derby champion. Takes an inside pitch, hammers the right field, hanging. Payne makes a leaping catch, smashes into the fence. And that's a big out. Nice Rosmano with some defense here in the second.
Yates with a line drive and pain.
Here's your replay. Yates went for the inside pitch.
Retreating to first is Hagelin.
Pulled it down the line. Payne got a nice jump.
Ryan's now got 9 hits in this World Series.
Pipe.
Start. Corner.
Strike! Don't matter where it lands, sir, where it came across.
Ryan Stovall's moved up the batting order. The shortstop Thursday night actually got hit by a pop fly down to foul territory and knocked his tooth out.
No pitch, no pitch.
Swung on, bouncer past the diving arena, base hit, but no pitch.
He called time.
And
Purcell coming in to discuss.
I understand.
Stovall actually lost his tooth. Hit by a pop fly, and Doc, who's a dentist, actually put the tooth back in.
We got time, no pitch. He turned his
back. No pitch. It's not that hard.
I understand.
Looks like we got our field camera, home plate camera back. Good shot of the scoreboard.
Alright, so no
Stovall with one on, one out.
Reset. Haglund at first, Stovall in the box.
Play.
Come on, give me another good pitch. Come on.
Line drive, base hit.
Stovall promptly ripped.
Didn't affect Stovall, and he's going to try for
second.
He's in ahead of the throw. Double for Stovall. Two on, one out. For Reggie Schulte, the left fielder. Looking at some more stats. Both teams with a 605 batting average coming in. Schulte just 1-for-1 coming into the game. Now they're doing some field maintenance. Schulte finally going to stand in. Runners on second and third. One out. Tying run at the plate. Swung on, hard shot, passed right up the middle.
And that's gonna be
he's going to score too easy. Schulte, a two RBI single. Cuts the lead to one. Bring up Orlando Castillo. 6-15, three homers, five RBIs coming into the game. Middle is wide open. There's Mano Stack on the defense on the left side. First pitch swinging.
Foul. One.
Pipe.
Lulu!
One.
Steele takes the ball. 1-1. One's hittable. Bouncer left side pass. Junior took a bad hop at the last second. Over his glove. Schulte goes first to third.
Schulte to third. Runners in the corners with one out for Stephen Lloyd.
Stephen Lloyd swung on deep to left. Collins looks up, balls up on the hill. Three-run shot and the lead for Backman. 12-10.
Home run. Schulte and Castillo in the score. It's 12-10. One out for Brian Logan.
Your replay with Stephen Lloyd got all that one. First pitch swinging by Logan. Base hit up the middle. Thrown behind a runner. Ball gets away from Sanchez. Logan on first. Andy Vitzak, the pitcher, going to try to roll it to the top.
Knocked for Brian Logan, so now stepping into the box. Number 18, playing out of Minneapolis, Minnesota,
it's
Andrew
Vitzak. Go. All right.
Pipe.
Backside single by Vitzak. Now Backman in a nice offensive rhythm here in the second. Seven runs across, one out. Top of the rack, Lee Powers. Powers, Kennington, and Hagelin been getting it done all year. Lee Powers, 727, three homers, 11 RBIs coming into the game.
Tight end.
Kennington, 643 with six homers. Swung on, base hit.
And Lee now aboard in all three plate appearances.
RBI single. Vitzak first to third, 13-10 to score.
Two on and one out for Kevin Kennington. 7-2 out of two.
What?
Kevin Kennington popped it up. That ball could be playable. Drifting back to the fence. And gone off the scoreboard. Kennington looked like he missed it about 400 feet.
Three-run shot for Kennington.
Three-run shot, 16-10.
Kevin's now driven in five in the game. He has driven in
eight. This is going to be a war.
And it's 16
I said he looked like he missed it, but the replay looked like he pretty much crushed it. Just got out about the 390 mark. Hagelin the batter.
Short.
Hagelin just under 600 coming into the game. Three homers.
Play.
Playing go Deadpool go. Second baseman Cannell all the way over towards the line.
Strike! Got a corner. Full count.
Santana in center way to over in front of the score or the monitor. And they had him positioned perfectly as Cannell makes the play, gets him by a step. That'll be the lefty Yates. Yates, 750, seven homers, 11 RBIs coming into the game. Playing him exactly the way they played Hagelin.
I got you. Right.
Play. Purcell with a nice clean one. Off the pitching rubber quick pitch.
Full count.
That one just missed. Full count. Must be fair to Yates. Two outs. Inside, he liked it. Popped it out. It's carrying to the warning track. Payne under makes the catch.
High, fly ball,
13-10, your score. Beckman put up 11 runs. They got a six-run lead. We'll go to the top of the third.
Side for Beckman in the second, but they answer Rismondo's 10. They put 11 on the board. They get 11 runs on 10 hits. We'll go to the top of the third. Due up for Rismondo.
Cocoa Beach, the authentic beach town, where the sand is our building blocks and a board is our preferred mode of transportation. A place where memories are awakened by the sound of a wave. It's the home of the original, home to the iconic, and home of the legendary. Cocoa Beach, it's still cool. Your beach vacation begins at GoCocoBeach.com.
Three experiences to have in one trip. GoTitusville.com.
Some of the commercials with the
play ball.
East Coast of Florida, where they're moving to Vieira, near where NASA is, the USSSA, moving their home office.
Here we go, guys.
A lot of their world tournaments will be played in Vieira, Florida in the future, all turf fields. Go to the beach, surf, and go to NASA, come down, play some softball. Still working on the field out there by second base. That may be a delay here as the grounds crew is going to be headed here next inning. 16-10 to score. Backman with 11 runs in the second. Rismondo had 10 runs in the top of the second. Scores are headed up. I'll be with you one more inning, and I'll do some of my media work down on the field, get some pictures. I'll come back for the end of the game.
Stepping into the box, lead things off for Rismondo. It'll be the shortstop, number 3, Don Didonatis. Don's got 11 hits so far this year.
Didonatis.
Play.
Payne, Sanchez, next three batters.
That's heavy.
Playing Didonatis straight away. Swung on. Right field. Catchable. Haglund's under it. Makes it. Catch
fly
one
ball
out.
To right field. Drifting underneath that one, Neil Haglund. One out for Lee Payne.
Lee Payne, center field, hit in a bad spot. Center fielder Logan was there. Two up. Two up, two down. Sanchez, the batter. Swinging the hot stick. Five homers and seven at-bats. Sanchez out of California. Backup pitcher, but he's worked his way into the lineup at first base. Kennington right on the first base line defensively. Lloyd shallow right field at second. First two balls. That one strike, full count. Sanchez resets, payoff pitch, up the middle, base hit, right over the leaping Fitzek.
And that's right back through the box from Sanchez, so he sets the table. And we go back to the top of the order for the second baseman, number 14, the most valuable player in the 2013 World Series, Greg Cannell.
Greg Cannell, the league triple crown winner. Second year in a row, he led the league in on-base percentage, home runs, and RBIs. Outside, walking.
And that's the base on balls for Cannell, so now two on for the Hall of Famer, the pitcher, Andy Purcell.
Throwing Cannell unhittable pitches right there. Bring up Purcell, has been pulling the ball hard. Popped him up, left side, Stovall under it. That'll do it. Rosmondo is 0 in the first and 0 in the third. But in between there, they got 10. They're still in the game. 16-10, Beckman coming up bottom of the third.
UAAA is the stage where the nation's top sports stars shine for the country to see. On the diamond, the top baseball players are looking to be chosen by the Select 30 and compete as a team at the National Amateur Baseball Championships. In Fast Pitch, USA Elite selected the World Fast Pitch Championships brings together premier players and teams from across the country to play for the title and continue their dream of one day playing professional softball. While Nationwide Conference UAAA hosts the stars of slow pitch softball. Take your game to the next level. Play the best. Play UAAA.
We are back. Backman looking to add to their six-run lead here in the bottom of the third. Rosmondo, if you're just joining us in the orange, dropped to the loser's bracket by 3rd Street on Thursday night, fighting their way back with two wins yesterday, including a come-from-behind victory over line drive. And Backman losing in the semifinals to Smash It Sports late last night. And both of these teams who were favored to win the major would have to win 5 in a row today against some stiff competition. Stovall pops it up, out of play. Stovall on first, Schulte the batter. Schulte broke into the conference with that great run that Fence Brokers made back in 2010. Played great at the major that year. He's been climbing the ladder of teams ever since. It's a deep to right center, but caught back there in the shadows by Santana. Runner moves up.
Drifting over to gather that one in is Nick Santana. So there's now one out.
One out, Castillo, the batter.
Stepping into the box, the middle infielder, Orlando Castillo.
Miss hit it. Bouncer out front of the plate. It's going to be an infield single.
And Orlando
by Castillo. Hit it in no man's land. Purcell not happy with that one.
The runner at first and second with one out for Steven.
Probably the worst hit of the tournament right there. Stephen Lloyd, the batter, first and second, one out. Swung on deep. Back goes Santana into the shadows. Leaps. And I think the ball ricocheted back toward second base. Santana tracks it down. It's going to be a long RBI double and a 17-10 lead for Backman. The ball went into the shadows. I lost track of it. Hit about the 395 mark right in front of the scoreboard. Here's your replay. Santana just missed it. Curved over his head. Then he had to track it down. Brian Logan, the batter. Second and third. One out. Playing Logan to pull, but he can use the whole field. There it is. Floating, but falling in front of Santana's going to score two. 19 runs across for Backman here. Just the third inning. We're not even halfway. Runner on first is Logan. He runs well. And Andy Vitsack, the pitcher, has had a good year hitting. Coming into this game, 4-for-9. He does have power down the left field line. Time called, no pitch. Backside, Cannell keeps it in front, flips to second. Out at second. Let's see if we can get a replay on that one. Logan runs well, so Cannell probably should have went to first. Wow, that was close. Probably just out, I think. Good call. Cannell bodied it up at second base. Chose to go to second. He probably forgot that Logan was running. He did have time to first. They got the out anyways, two outs. Lee Powers, former Rosamondo player, standing in. Powers been hitting good line drives. He got this one up in the air. It's going to carry to the fence. Collins looks up, and it's gone. Two-run homer. And now Backman going to start to push some run rules. They're up by 11. Run rule is 30 after 3, 20 after 4, 15 after 5. There, Collins, who robbed a home run yesterday against line drive. Watches that one go out. Kevin Kennington hit it in the same spot. This one's well out of here. Up on the hill, Kennington is known for the distance on his homers. Gets a solo, 22-10.
And that's now six in the inning. It's 22-10 for Neil Haglund.
Wind is now blowing across from the clock towards the third base dugout, but it's not affecting these last few swings. Haglund first pitch swinging right at the second baseman, goes over Cannell's glove, and now there's interference at first. He'll go to second. He's safe anyways. Haglund hustling out of the box, gets a, I don't know if they call that an error or a double. Jeremy Yates, the batter. Yates due to get into one here. Now timeout. John Rector, the manager, is going to come out and discuss it.
And the Hall of Famer, John Rector, out to the mound for a conference.
John Rector. Winner of that game, of course, will take on the loser of the winner's bracket champion chip between Scene and Smash It Sports. And of course, the winner of that will have to go for the championship and win two games. 2016 U-SSSA Major World Series. Bouncer right side. Cannell's got it. It's going to throw to first. Gets Yates. Nice play by Cannell. Rismondo finally gets out of the inning. Six runs across for Backman. They lead 22-10. I am going to leave you there, and I'll be back for the end of the game. Thanks.
But Backman picks up six more runs. They get those six runs on five hits.
How did I get there? I played against the best. How did I get there? I challenged myself. How did I get there? I raised my level of competition.
USA Elite Select. Your legacy starts here.
It's going to be an infield single to get things started for Rismondo. Bubba Mack aboard. And now stepping into the box, it'll be the catcher, number 15, B.J. Falk.
She put the hurt, it hurts. She put the why, it tries. She put the S.O.B. in sober. She put the hang, it hangs over.
And that's going to be a ground rule double left for BJ Culp. That one, one hops out of the stadium. So two aboard and into the box, Andrew Collins. Run triple for Andrew Collins. So three straight hits here to start things in the fourth. And now into the box, Nick Santana. That's an RBI double for Nick Santana. Collins trots home to score. And it's now 22-13, nobody out, for Luis Reyna. Fly ball to center field, drifting back together, Brian Logan. Santana tags and goes to third. There's one out for the shortstop, Don DeDonatis. DeDonatis with the infield single. Coming in to score is Nick Santana. That's four across. Brings up the right fielder, Lee Payne. And the ground ball up the middle, fielded nicely, just beating DeDonatis to the bag. It's the shortstop Stovall, so there's now two away. Paint aboard on the fielder's choice. And into the box is Dan Sanchez. two away, Lee Payton first, and in the box, Sam Sanchez. Fly ball to right field, drifting in together, Neil Haglund, and that'll retire the side. In the inning, Rizmondo gets four runs. They get four runs on five hits. We'll go to the bottom half. Two up, Stovall, Schulte, and Castillo.
Quality, consistency, durability.
Ryan Stovall in to lead things off. Ryan, 3 out of 3. Fly ball to left from Stovall, gathered in by Collins. There's one away for Reggie Schulte. High pop in the shallow left. Reyna calls everybody off. Two away. And now into the box, Orlando Castillo. Knock for Orlando. He is 4 out of 4 in the ball game. Now stepping into the box, it'll be the second baseman, number 1, Stephen Lloyd. High fly ball to center field. Santana gathers it in. And for the first time today, Backman goes down without scoring. They get one hit. They 3-1. Will go to the fifth. It's Backman 22, Rosmondo 14. Due up, it's the top of the order. Cannell, Purcell, and Mack.
For those who serve. For those who protect. For those who save.
For those who have sacrificed.
The Heroes Tour is dedicated to you.
Greg Cannell gets things started with the big blast. For Greg, that's his second home run of the ball game, his eighth home run of the series. 22-15, nobody out for the pitcher, Andy Purcell. Hot smash by Purcell, but a nice play at short, and then a nice dig by Kennington, so there's one away for Bubba Mack. Solid knock in the left center field for Bubba Mack. Bubba now 3 out of 4. So after Mack's double, stepping into the box, it'll be the catcher, B.J. Falk. Yeah. Dave Polk doubles into left center field. Bubba Mack in to score. One out, one on, and now into the box the left fielder, Andrew Collins. Ryan Sobol, shown a nice range and a great arm, nails Andrew Collins for the second out of the inning, and now into the box, Nick Santana. And hold up, Andrew appears to have hurt himself. Let's hope he's okay. Well, it's good to see Andrew up and walking. So let's reset the stage. There's two outs, two runs to score. BJ Falk is at second, and Nick Santana is your batter. Nick, 3 out of 3 so far in the game. And Nick is now 4 out of 4. Bangs the base hit from the shallow center field. He's in with the double, and BJ Falk through with the third run of the inning. So now into the box, it'll be the middle infielder, Luis Ringa. That's the base hit to left field. There are two outs. Runners are at the corners for Don DeDonatis. Base knock for DeDonatis. Santana in to score. Reyna scoots to third. Runners are at the corners with two outs for Lee Payne. And a long run, but a nice play in deep right center field. Brian Logan up to the challenge. Tracks down Payne's line drive, and that'll retire the side. In the inning, Rismondo gets 4 runs. They get the 4 runs on 6 hits. They strand 2. We'll go to the bottom of the 5th and 2 up for Backman. It'll be Logan, Vitzek, and Powers. Stepping in to lead things off, the center fielder number 2, Brian Logan. Bounces that one through the box, and that's going to be a stand-up double. And ladies and gentlemen, your attention please. We have a pinch hitter announced. Batting in place of Andrew Bitkek. Number 48, Terry Baggs. Baggs is your batter. Ground ball up the middle, fielded nicely by Rainey, clips to first, one away. On the play, Logan moves to third, and now into the box, Lee Powers. Lee, aboard in all four trips, he homered in his last at bat. And a hot smash right back to the box, but Andy Purcell snags it, stares down Logan, flips out Powers. So now two outs, runners still at third for Kevin Kennington. Base on balls for Kevin Kennington. So now two on with two out for Neil Hagelin. A hot smash and a nice play by Dan Sanchez. And so Backman puts up another goose egg. It's 22-18. We've got two innings to play. It's anybody's ball game. Do up Sanchez, Cannell, and Purcell.
Each and every day you come out here to the park, you give everything you got.
Behind every good team is a great coach.
Our hands are out here.
Hey, this is Brett Helmer. We are out here testing out and shooting some video of our new 2016 bat line. This is a 2016 Bryson Baker 13.5-inch two-piece bat.
The balance point keeps you more consistent as a hitter.
This is the Scott Kirby 2016 12-inch barrel, end loaded.
Coming off of baseball background, I need something that's end loaded. My bat's got a lot of it.
Brian Wegman, 2016, Realtree Camo.
My miss hits down the barrel, I still get good performance out of it.
2016, Helmer, two-piece, connection zero. I like my bat as heavy as I can get it. 2016 Mako Torque with a 360-degree rotating torque handle. It'll let you stay in the hitting zone a little bit longer. This is a 2016 long barrel end load in Realtree camo. This thing looks great. Defense.
So now we go to the top of the order for Greg Cannell. Knock for Cannell, that'll bring in Sanchez. Now a 22-19 game, and into the box, the Hall of Famer, Andy Purcell. So Andy Purcell draws the base on balls. Two on, nobody out. And now at the box, representing the tying run, number 25, the third baseman, Bubba Mack. Knocked to right field for Mack. Sinking line drive. Haglund able to keep it in front of him, but now they're loaded up for B.J. Falk. High fly ball to right field. Credit to BJ with an RBI as Cannell tags and scores. Now 22-20, but one out and runners at the corners for Andrew Collins. RBI single to right center field for Collins. Trotting in to score is Purcell. Motor into third is Mack. So now the tying run is at third base. The go-ahead run at first, and in the box, Nick Santana. All my life, Fly ball to right field from Santana. For the first time all day, they're able to retire Nick, but credit him with an RBI sacrifice fly as Bubba Mac tags and scores, and we are tied up at 22 apiece. So now stepping into the box, it'll be the middle infielder, number 22, Luis Reyna. Fly ball, center field, drifting back, Brian Logan. That'll retire the side here in the sixth. Rizmondo gets four runs. They get those four runs on the strength of four hits. They have drawn even. So we go to the bottom of the sixth. Due up for Backman. It'll be Yates, Stovall, and Schulte.
Come on, Mike!
I'm Lauren Chamberlain, first baseman for the USSSA Pride. I really like to feel good when I swing. I don't like to overcomplicate things. So I find myself often just hitting into a bone net, visualizing what I want to do, and then taking that with me on the field. Even on an off day, I love to get some hacks in. When I have a quick 30 minutes, the bone net is super easy to set up. I grab my bat, a bucket of balls, and I swing until I feel good. Bone net, play anywhere, play now.
Stepping in to lead things off for Backman. Here in the bottom of the sixth, it'll be the cleanup hitter, number 30, Jeremy Yates. That's going to be a two-bagger off the wall, and now Yates is going to try and turn it into three, and he is in. So a hustling Jeremy Yates makes it a leadoff triple with a go-ahead run at third. And now stepping into the box, it'll be the shortstop Ryan Stovall. Ryan, three out of four in the ballgame. To left for Stovall, and he makes the turn. He is going to hustle in with the two-bagger. So give Ryan an RBI double. Yates in to score the go-ahead run. One on, nobody out, and we have a pinch hitter announced. Batting in place of Reggie Schulte, number 35, Ryan Harvey. Harvey is your batter. ball well hit to left center field. Gone. Ryan Harvey comes off the bench banging a two-run home run, and that'll make it 25-22. Bases cleared for Orlando Castillo. And that's the base hit for Orlando Castillo as he grounds it up the middle for the first 4 men in reach for Backman here in the sixth. And now stepping into the box, it'll be the second baseman, number one, Stephen Lloyd. Line drive, but going down to get it deep in the hole is DeDonatis. So now one away, and stepping into the box, the center fielder, Brian Logan. Center field. Castillo to second, Logan aboard with the single, two on and one out. And now stepping into the box, he re-entered the pitcher, number 18, Andrew Vinkay. Line drive to right field from Vitek. Nice play made there. So now two away, and we go to the top of the order, and it looks like Lee Powers is going to re-enter. Lee Powers is your batter. So credit Powers with the RBI single, but then when Brian Logan tries to go to third, Andy Purcell alertly covering the bag, and he takes the throw and applies the tag. So in the inning, Backman gets 4 runs. They get those 4 runs on the strength of 6 hits. And as we head to the top of the seventh, Rismondo's going to need 4 to tie, 5 to take the lead, 2 up.
Twenty-six-22, Backman leads. Deidonatis takes a strike. Last 3 batters in the order for Rismondo. They need 4 to tie. Keep this game going here in the top of the 7th. They scored 10 in the 2nd and 4 runs apiece in the 4th, 5th, and 6th innings. Playing Deidonatis straight up. Swung on line drive. Coming on hard as Logan makes a catch for out number 1.
Center field gathered by Brian Logan. So 1 out for the right fielder, Lee Payne.
Nice play to end that last inning where Purcell, the pitcher, was covering third when Logan tried to take third on the ball that got past Bubba Mack. And they threw out Logan at third. That was a huge out with Kennington on deck to keep it fairly close. Lee Payne the batter. Playing Payne pretty much straight up. Bouncer up the middle, backhanded by Vitsack. Pitches it underhand to first base for the out. 2 outs. Now Rismondo down to their last out. What's been a roller coaster season for them against Backman. And the unfortunate luck that the 2 top teams meet here in the loser's bracket. First thing Saturday morning. This last out's been tough to get for teams over the years against the 10-time champs. That's catchable. Schulte comes on and makes the catch. That'll do it. Backman advances. They'll take on the winner of Combat and 3rd Street next. And then we'll have the winner's final after that. Vitsack and the boys fired up after the big 26-22 win. And we'll leave you right there. We'll be back in a few minutes with the next game. Combat vs. 3rd Street coming up.
For Rismondo, they'll finish this series with a record of 3-2. They will finish in a tie for 5th place. So the team that has won 9 of the last 11 World Series will not be winning it this year. Your final score, 26-22 Backman. And now coming your way in just a few minutes, it'll be game number 29 in your bracket. It'll be a matchup between 3rd Street and Team Combat.